Welcome. In today's lecture, we will study this topic, curvature. We have studied three applications till now in this subject. We have studied applications of differentiation in the form of Taylor series expansion, Maclaurin series expansion, and in the form of concavity and curvature, concavity in convexity, and in the form of asymptotes. So we have studied three applications. This is the fourth application of derivatives and the concept of differentiation. Curvature means bending. Straight line, as we can understand, straight line has no bending, but all the remaining curves have some bending at every point. Now, for example, this circle. So we can see that there are bends everywhere, and we have intuitive meaning of bending, and through that we can say that if I draw two curves and if I locate these two points, then you can, by looking at these two curves and these two points P and Q, we can say that bending at P is more than the bending at Q. So bending at Q is less than the bending at P. So this is our intuitive answer. Now, to make this topic a subject of mathematical investigation, we need to have a precise meaning for, we need to have a precise tool to measure the bending and curvature in terms of mathematical quantities. So for that, I draw a figure with x-axis and y-axis, and I consider a curve. Suppose at this point P, you want to measure, we want to check the bending, the curvature. Then we have ideas about tangents, so we can draw tangents at any point of the curve. Suppose the given curve has equation y equal to fx. Suppose the given curve has equation y equal to fx. Now if we draw a tangent at point P, then we know that it will subtend an angle psi. Next, I consider another neighboring point to P. Suppose this point is Q with some other coordinate, x plus delta x, y plus delta y. Now we can draw tangent at Q also. Suppose Q subtend an angle psi plus delta psi with the positive direction of x-axis. Then, by applying some trigonometry, we can observe that this angle between the tangent will be equal to delta psi, will be equal to the difference of these two angles. Now, if we observe what the delta psi represents, so delta psi represents the angle subtended by the tangent at P, subtended by the tangent at P to reach the tangent at Q. So if I move the point P to Q along the curve, then the tangent at P will move to the tangent at Q. Then the angle subtended by this tangent while we are moving from point P to point Q is being measured by this angle delta psi. And we observe that this angle delta psi will be more if the band between the RPQ is more. If the band between the RPQ is more, then the angle will be larger. And if the band between P and Q is less than the delta sign will be less. So we take delta sign as a measurement of bending or curvature. So we write that total curvature of arc PQ is delta psi. Now suppose the arc length of PQ, suppose the arc length of PQ arc is equal to delta S, then the average curvature between P and Q at any point, then the average curvature will be delta psi by delta S. So this represents average curvature. Now if I move point P towards Q, then delta psi tends to 0, then delta psi tends to 0. The angle between the tangent at P and Q becomes 0 because I move tangent at P to, I move the point P to Q, so the tangent at P reaches the tangent at Q, coincides with the tangent at Q. Therefore, as P tends to Q, we get curvature at a point P or Q. We get a curvature at a point P or Q as this. Limit delta psi tends to 0. Limit delta S tends to 0. Delta psi by delta S. So we can write delta psi tends to 0 because, and delta S tends to 0 because P then move towards Q, the arc length also tend to 0. So according to the idea of limit and differential calculus, this limit represents the derivative of psi with respect to S. So we can calculate curvature at any point P by calculating this derivative d psi by ds. Now this derivative is in terms of S and psi. So if we have equation of the curve, in terms of S and psi, if we have equation of the curve in terms of S and psi, then we can calculate the curvature of that curve at any point using this formula d psi by ds. And the equation of the curve in terms of S and psi is known as intrinsic form. Usually, you may not have the intrinsic form of the curve. Most of the time, we study Cartesian curve or parametric curves like that. So we will convert this formula into Cartesian form or in the parametric form for our purpose. But if we have an equation of the curve in intrinsic form, then we can use this formula to find the curvature. For example, if we have an equation of the curve like this, S equal to C tan psi, for example, then we can calculate the curvature at any point in terms of S and psi by applying this formula d psi by ds. So for this purpose, we differentiate the given equation with respect to psi. So when we differentiate, we get ds upon d psi equal to c differentiation of tan psi sec square psi. So we get d psi by ds equal to d psi by ds equal to 1 upon c sec square psi. So this will give me the value of curvature at any point. So if we have intrinsic curve, then we can straightforwardly calculate the curvature simply by differentiating. Now, what more term we want to study? That is, we will frequently refer bending in the form of radius of curvature. Radius of curvature is defined as the reciprocal of the curvature. So, in terms of intrinsic form, the radius of curvature will be given by ds by d psi, the reciprocal of curvature, because curvature is equal to d psi by ds. So the radius of curvature is equal to ds upon d psi. And usually we denote radius of curvature by this symbol rho. So this represents rho, Greek symbol. And one more point which we can see for circle. If you observe the circle, so by intuitive meaning, you will observe that the bending at every point of the circle is uniform. The bending at any point of the circle is uniform. And bending at any point of the circle is uniform, therefore curvature will remain same at all the points. And you will find that the radius of curvature for the circle, if we consider an equation of the circle, the radius of curvature for circle will be the radius of circle. Further, next we will study how to convert the idea of curvature for the Cartesian curve. So next we will study the curvature and radius of curvature for Cartesian curve. So here we have this formula for radius of curvature. In books, sometimes curvatures are denoted by this Greek symbol kappa. Usually to solve problem, most of the time we use this word radius of curvature. So, if the curve is given in intrinsic form, then the calculation of radius of curvature is straightforward. Now, we develop a formula for the radius of curvature in Cartesian coordinate. Radius of curvature in Cartesian coordinates. So, radius of curvature in Cartesian coordinates. Now, we have radius of curvature equal to ds by d psi in terms of intrinsic equation. So, we will use this formula to get our Cartesian coordinate formula for the radius of curvature. For that, we know about psi. That tan psi is equal to dy by dx. If we have a curve y equal to fx, then tan psi is equal to dy by dx. Next, we can differentiate both the sides with respect to x. Then we get sec square psi d psi by dx, because we are differentiating with respect to x, equal to dy by d2y by dx square. So I have differentiated tan psi equal to dy by dx with respect to x. So we get sec square psi into d psi by dx equal to d2y by dx square. Now what I do is I can write d psi by dx equal to d dxi by ds and into ds by dx. So I write dxi by dx in this form, dxi by ds into ds by dx, and s represents the arc length, and we have a standard rule, standard formula for derivative of arc, which says that ds by dx is equal to square root of 1 plus dy by dx over square. So we can use this formula here, and then we will observe that the ds by dxi will be obtained in this form. Ds by dxi will be 1 plus dy by dx whole square to the power 3 by 2 upon d2y by dx square. So after some simplification and substitution of these values, and using the fact that sec square psi is equal to 1 plus tan square psi, we will replace tan psi by dy by dx here, and then we will have this formula. So ds by dxi equal to 1 plus dy by dx square power 3 by 2 upon dy by dx square gives us a formula for calculating the radius of curvature in terms of Cartesian coordinate. So if we have Cartesian coordinate equation y to fx, we can differentiate y to fx and get dy by dx, and we can differentiate it twice to have dy by dx square. We can substitute the values of the derivatives here to have the value of the radius of curvature in terms of x, y. And if you want to calculate radius of curvature at a particular point, then we will calculate the values of the derivatives at those particular points. So we will see all these things by example. So as a first example, I calculate radius of curvature of parabola. Radius of curvature of parabola. So we know the equation of the parabola is y square equal to 4ax, and we want to calculate the radius of curvature of y square equal to 4ax. So we start differentiating this function, and we will try to calculate dy by dx and d2y by dx square. So we need the Cartesian coordinate formula, which is available here. So we differentiate. Differentiating, we get 2y dy by dx equal to 4a. So we have dy by dx equal to 2a upon y. Next, we will also need second derivative. So we differentiate it again. Then we get d2y by dx square equal to minus 2a upon y square into dy by dx. And here we know the value of dy by dx. So we can substitute the value of dy by dx here to have minus 4a square upon y. So our second derivative in terms of y is minus 4a square upon y cube, and the first derivative is 2a upon y. So now we use this formula to find the radius of curvature of the parabola at xy, means in terms of xy. So the radius of curvature will be equal to 1 plus dy by dx square, means 4a square upon y square power 3 by 2 upon second derivative. Second derivative will be equal to minus 4a square upon y. Now we simplify the terms. So you will observe that we will get y square plus 4a square power 3 by 2 in the numerator, and in the denominator we will get minus 4a square. So here we are getting the value of rho as negative. Now because rho represents the radius of curvature, which is a length, so we can ignore this minus sign because of this radical, because of this square root factor here, we can choose plus minus sign and we can ignore this negative sign of the radius of curvature to have positive value of the radius of curvature in terms of y. So we have in terms of y, radius of curvature equal to y square plus 4a square power 3 by 2 upon 4a square. If you want to convert the find the radius of curvature in terms of x only, then you can use the equation of the curve and you can put y square equal to 4ax here, and then you can take 4a common, and accordingly we can get the radius of curvature in terms of x also. If you want to calculate radius of curvature at any particular point of this curve, in that case you can put the value of y here corresponding to that point and you can get the radius of curvature at that point. So in this way we have understood how to calculate the radius of curvature. Next, I try to calculate the radius of curvature of the circuit x square plus y square equal to a square. You know, this is the equation of a circuit with center 0, 0 and radius a. So if we try to calculate the radius of curvature of the circuit by using this formula, then we will get, by differentiating, we will get 2x plus 2y into dy by dx equal to 0, and dy by dx will be equal to minus x upon y. Next, we need second derivative. So we calculate second derivative for the circuit. So first we have calculated radius of curvature for parabola, and second we are calculating radius of curvature of circuit. So we have dy by dx. Now we differentiate it again with respect to x to have second derivative. So d2y by dx square is equal to, according to differentiation will be as per the quotient rule. So we will have y square, y differentiation of x1 minus x differentiation of y dy by dx. Now we put the value of dy by dx here. So we see that dy by dx is equal to minus x upon y. So here we get x square upon y square. Now if we simplify it, we get y square plus x square upon y cube. So we observe that the second derivative is this, minus y square plus x square upon y cube. But because of the equation of the curve, we know that the value of x square plus y square is a square. So the second derivative is equal to minus a square upon y cube. Now we have first derivative and second derivative, so we can calculate the radius of curvature raw by applying this formula of radius of curvature. So this radius of curvature will be equal to 1 plus dy by dx square. So x square upon y square here, power 3 by 2 upon d2y by dx square. So minus a square upon y cube here. Now we can ignore this minus sign because of the fact that rho is the radius of curvature which represents length. So we ignore this negative sign and we have a square root factor here which will have 2 sign plus minus. So we can ignore it mathematically without any loss of generality. So if we simplify, we will get y square plus x square to the power 3 by 2 upon a square, and this y cube will get cancelled because in the denominator we will have y square. So when it will come out of this bracket, it will Now we have x square plus y square equal to a square. When we put that here, we get a cube in the numerator, a square in the denominator. So we get radius of curvature equal to a. So you can observe that the radius of curvature for a circle, radius of curvature for a circle is actually equal to the radius of the circle itself. Okay, so the curvature of the circle will be equal to 1 upon a everywhere. So radius of curvature is a, and curvature of this circle will be 1 upon a, the reciprocal of the radius of the circle. And you will find that at any point of the circle, the radius of curvature and curvature will remain constant. So that is why we say that circle will have equal bending at each of its point. Next we consider other curves and we try to find the radius of curvature for those curves. This time I take an example in which we need to find radius of curvature of this curve 4 sin x minus sin 2x at a given point x equal to pi by 2. So what we can, to solve these types of problems, what we can do, we can proceed in this way and we can obtain a general formula for radius of curvature in terms of x and y, and then at last we can put the value of the point. For alternative way, we can also use these values initially while calculating d of radius. So we can first calculate the values of the derivatives at these points, and then we can put all those values directly into this formula to get the radius of curvature at this point. So you see, so first differentiation will be equal to 4 cos x and 2 cos 2x. Second derivative will be equal to minus 4 sin x minus plus 4 sin 2x. Now we can calculate the value of ys at these points. So at x equal to pi by 2, cos pi by 2 is 0, so we get ys equal to 0. So ys is 0 at this point, x equal to pi by 2. And when we put x equal to pi by 2 here, we get sin pi by 2. So sin pi by 2 is 1. But here we can observe that when we put x equal to pi by 2, cos pi by 2 is 0. But here we will have cos pi, which will be equal to minus 1. So we will have 0 plus 2, because cos pi will be equal to minus 1. So we will have 2 here. So our y dash is equal to 2 at x equal to pi by 2. Next we put x equal to pi by 2 here. So sin pi by 2 is 1 and sin pi is 0. So we get here minus 4. So our radius of curvature at x equal to pi by 2 will be equal to 1 plus 2 square power 3 by 2 upon minus 4. And we will have a plus minus sign here, so we can ignore this minus sign, and we will have our answer 5 root 5 upon 4. So what we get is that the radius of curvature of this curve at x equal to pi by 2 is 5 root 5 by 4. Similarly, we can calculate radius of curvature of other curves. So as you found that while calculating second derivative, in many of the problems while calculating second derivative, we can use the given equation of the curve to simplify the value of the second derivative and to simplify the value of radius of curvature also. So you can note this point while trying to solve problems of other Cartesian curve. We can use this idea to simplify our answers. So next I am considering similar type of the radius of curvature and the second derivative. For example, consider root x plus root y equal to root a. And the question is given like this, that find the radius of curvature, find the radius of curvature at any point xy. So we have to calculate radius of curvature in general. So first we try to calculate the first derivative. For that we differentiate it, 1 upon 2 root x plus 1 upon 2 root y into dy by dx equal to 0. So what we get is that dy by dx is equal to minus root y upon x. Dy by dx is equal to minus root y upon x. And next, or we can write it more simply, minus y to the power half upon x to the power half. Next we start our calculation for second derivative, d2y by dx square. So we apply division rule with a minus sign, because we have minus sign here. So we put minus sign here and we differentiate y to the power half upon x to the power half. So in the denominator square, so x denominator as such, differentiation of y to the power half will give me half y to the power minus half minus y to the, because I am differentiating y, so I will have dy by dx here minus x to the power half, and then differentiation of y to the power half. Now I keep y to the power half as such and differentiate x to the power half. So I get half x to the power minus half. Now we have value of dy by dx. The value of dy by dx is equal to minus y to the power half upon x to the power half. So here the value is y to the power half into y to the power minus half will get cancelled, x to the power half and x to the power half will get cancelled. So we will have minus half only. So we will have minus half here only, and next we will have minus half y to the power half upon x to the power half upon x. Now if we further simplify, then we can observe that we can take minus common, so it will become plus. We can also take half common, so we will have half outside, and we will have x to the power half plus y to the power half in the numerator, and in the denominator we will have x to the power 3 by 2. Now we can use the given equation of the curve to simplify our second derivative, and we can write that x to the power half plus y to the power half is equal to a to the power half. So we get a to the power half upon 2 into x to the power 3 by 2 as the value of the second derivative. Now after the calculation of first and second derivative, we can use this formula to find the radius of curvature. So you see the radius of curvature for this problem will be equal to 1 plus dy by dx square. So we will have here y upon x to the power 3 by 2 upon the value of the second derivative, which is a to the power half upon 2 into x to the power 3 by 2. And now we can simplify to have x to the, to have x plus y to the power 3 by 2 in the numerator, and we will have x to the power 3 by 2 will get cancelled, so we will have 2 here, and in the denominator we will have a to the power half. So after some simplification, we get the value of radius of curvature equal to this, 2 into x plus y to the power 3 by 2 upon a to the power half. So here you can observe that we use the given curve to find the value of the second derivative, but the value of the given equation of the curve was not used while calculating the radius of curvature. Now if someone ask us to find the radius of curvature at this point, 1 by
use this formula directly to
find the radius of curvature, and for that we can differentiate x with respect to t twice to have x dot and x double dot, and similarly we can differentiate y with respect to t to have first order derivative and second order derivative in terms of t, and we can put those values of the derivatives here in this formula. Instead of applying this formula, alternatively we can use the Cartesian form of the curve to find the radius of curvature of the parametric curve when it is. According to that method, first if you have a parametric form, then first you can calculate dx by dt and dy by dt, and from these two calculations you can calculate dy by dx by this formula, that dy by dx will be equal to dy by dt upon dx by dt. So you will get your dy by dx in terms of t. Dy by dx in terms of t. Now you can calculate d2y by dx square by differentiating both the sides with respect to x. So if we differentiate both the sides with respect to x, on the left hand side we get d2y by dx square, on the right hand side we get y less t, means differentiation of y t with respect to t into dt by dx, and the value of dt by dx will be available from the reciprocal of dx by dt, because we know that the first order derivative reciprocal can be calculated by calculating the reciprocal of the original derivative. So we can calculate second derivative this way, and then we will have the value of dy by dx and d2 by dx square. So instead of using this parametric form, we can also use the Cartesian form to calculate the radius of curvature of a curve given in parametric form. For example, I consider a parametric curve, and then I will illustrate the calculation of the radius of curvature for that parametric curve using the formula for Cartesian curve to find the radius of curvature. So I take this example. So we have a parametric curve x equal to a cos cube theta, a cos cube theta, y equal to a sin cube theta, and the question is to find the radius of curvature of this curve. So what I will illustrate, the way to find the radius of curvature of this curve in terms of theta, without using this parametric formula for radius of curvature. We will use our old Cartesian coordinate formula to find the radius of curvature. So how can we use that formula to find the radius of curvature of this parametric curve? For that we differentiate with respect to theta, so we get dx by d theta equal to 3a cos square theta into minus sin theta. So this is the differentiation of a cos cube theta. Next, we differentiate y with respect to theta. This time we get 3a sin square theta into cos theta. From these two values, we can calculate dy by dx. So we observe that dy by dx will be equal to dy by d theta upon dx by d theta. So we will have 3a sin square theta into cos theta in the numerator, and minus 3a cos square theta into sin theta in the denominator. Next we observe that we can cancel 3a, we can cancel sin theta, we can cancel cos theta. So we get minus 10 theta as the value of dy by dx. Next, we calculate the d2y by dx square by applying this idea. So to calculate d2y by dx square, I differentiate both the sides with respect to x. On the right hand side, I get a function of theta. So I differentiate it with respect to theta. So I get x square theta into, then I differentiate theta with respect to x. Now I have the value of d theta by dx. The value of d theta by dx will be the reciprocal of this value of dx by d theta. So I use this value of dx by d theta to write the value of d theta by dx. So I write minus secant square theta upon 3 upon minus 3a cos square theta sin theta. So I have substituted the value of dx by d theta here. So I get this. Now when I simplify, I observe that I get 1 upon 3a secant square theta is, so I convert this secant square theta into sin theta cos theta. So I will have sin theta into cos to the power of 4 theta in the denominator. And my dy by dx is equal to minus 10 theta, and I convert it into sin and cos to have minus sin theta upon cos theta. Now we can apply our Cartesian coordinate formula to calculate the radius of curvature of this parametric curve. So we write the value of dy by dx and d2y by dx square, d2y by dx square. So we can simply substitute the values. One plus this dy by dx square is this sin square theta upon cos square theta to the power 3 by 2 upon d2y by dx square value 1 upon 3a sin theta cos to the power 4 theta. So when we try to simplify, we get cos square theta plus sin square theta in the numerator, cos square theta plus sin square theta to the power 3 by 2 in the numerator, which will become 1 because sin square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. And in the denominator, we will have cos square theta, we will come out of the bracket as cos cube theta. Then cos cube theta will get cancelled with this number cos to the power 4 theta to have cos theta only. So finally, we will have 1 upon 3a sin theta cos theta. So ultimately the radius of curvature is equal to 3a sin theta cos theta. So we can calculate, here I have illustrated the fact that we can calculate the radius of curvature of a parametric curve by using the formula for radius of curvature of Cartesian curve. So this is the radius of curvature of this curve in terms of theta. Next, I take one more example on parametric curve and I try to find the radius of curvature for that curve. So this time we have a curve x equal to a theta plus sin theta, y equal to a 1 minus cos theta, and the question is that find radius of curvature at any point theta in general. So first I calculate dx by d theta, then I find that dx by d theta is equal to a 1 plus cos theta. Next I calculate dy by d theta. So then I find that it is equal to a sin theta, because the differentiation of cos theta will be minus sin theta. So these are the values of dy by d theta and dx by d theta. From here I can calculate the value of dy by dx. The value of dy by dx will be equal to dy by d theta upon dx by d theta. So I get this. So we have this value of dy by dx. Now we can simplify this value of dy by dx, and we can convert the right hand side in terms of theta by 2 angle by applying a simple trigonometry. Then we can write sin theta as 2 sin theta by 2 into cos theta by 2, and we can write 1 plus cos theta as 2 cos square theta by 2. So using these well known formulas of trigonometry, we get dy by dx equal to tan theta by 2 in a very simplified form. So we have dy by dx equal to tan theta by 2. Next, we calculate the second derivative, d2y by dx square, by differentiating this relation with respect to x. So I differentiate right hand side with respect to, I have to differentiate right hand side with respect to x. For that I will differentiate it with respect to theta first, and then I will write d theta by dx. So the differentiation of tan theta by 2 with respect to theta will be sec square theta by 2 into 2 into half and into d theta by dx. Now I write the value of d theta by dx from this result. So we will have half secant square theta by 2 into one upon a 1 plus cos theta. So we can further simplify it to have our answer finally in terms of theta by 2. So we can write 1 plus cos theta as 2 cos square theta by 2. So we will have here 1 upon 4a, and in the numerator we will have secant to the power 4 theta by 2. So this is our second derivative, and our first derivative was tan theta by 2. Now we use these two values to find the radius of curvature of this curve. So we observe that the radius of curvature will be 1 plus dy by dx square, so tan square theta by 2 to the power 3 by 2 upon this 1 upon 4a and secant to the power 4 theta by 2. And when we simplify, we know from the denominator that 1 plus tan square theta by 2 is equal to sec square theta by 2. So we get sec cube theta by 2 in the numerator, and 1 upon 4a sec to the power 4 theta by 2 here. So we get 4a upon secant theta by 2, or more simply we can write it as 4a cos theta by 2. So this is the final simplified value of the radius of curvature of this curve, x to a theta plus sin theta, y to a 1 minus cos theta. Thank you.